In this video, we are going to learn all about tactile switches. What they are, how they work, how to interface them with prototyping boards like Evive and Arduino, and how to program them in PictoBlocks. Finally, we'll take a look at what wonders we can create using them. Let's begin by understanding what tactile switches are and how they work. Tactile switches, also known as push buttons, can be found everywhere, from phones to elevators to large industrial machines. They are the simplest type of input device. A push button helps in closing an open electronic circuit or the reverse temporarily during the time it is pressed. It has a small spring which helps it to return to its original position when the user takes off the pressure from the button. There are mainly two types of push buttons. First, normally open, second, normally closed. A circuit with a normally open push button is open by default. When the user presses the button, the circuit becomes complete and the current starts flowing through it. A circuit with a normally closed push button is closed by default. The circuit breaks on pressing the button. Now that we know how the push button works, let's have a look at how to interface it with Evive and see it in action. Evive already has two push buttons internally connected to digital pin 38 and pin 39. However, if you want to connect an external push button, you can make a circuit like this on Evive's breadboard. Now let's write a script to control Evive's push button 1, aka tactile switch 1 in PictoBlocks. It is a graphical programming software based on Scratch blocks. You can download it from the link given in the description box below. Before doing anything else, connect Evive to your computer using a USB cable. Next, open PictoBlocks. Then click on the board button and select Evive from the drop-down. Now from the dialog box that appears, choose the appropriate serial port. Before making the script, make sure that the firmware is uploaded. If not, upload it using the upload firmware button. Let's create a script to make our friendly neighborhood sprite, Toby, jump every time we press the tactile switch. First, select a backdrop of your choice. The first step is to check whether the tactile switch 1 is pressed or not. For that, add an if block in the scripting area and drop a tactile switch pressed block in its blank space. If you are using an external switch, you need to use a read state of digital pin block to check whether the switch is pressed or not. Select the pin to which you have connected the switch from the drop-down menu. Now let's continue with our script. Let's make Toby jump whenever the tactile switch 1 is pressed. Add a change YY block from the motion palette and write 50 in the space given. To bring it back to the original position, add a wait block of 1 second and duplicate the entire set and write minus 50 in the space of the second change YY block. Now we want this script to run forever, so we will put a forever block around it. Now, we'll place a when flag clicked had block above the forever block. It will ensure that the script runs when the green flag is clicked. Press the flag and watch Toby jump every time you press the tactile switch. Since everything is perfectly fine, let's write a script to work with the tactile switch without having Evive connected to the computer. For that, we'll have to work in the upload mode. First, switch to the upload mode by toggling this button. Now, let's create a script to turn the LED connected to Evive's pin 13 on every time we press the tactile switch. Add an if block to check if the tactile switch 1 is pressed. Place a tactile switch pressed block inside the hexagonal space of the if-else block. Since we need to turn the LED on, add a set digital pin block and set the output as high under the if arm. To turn the LED off, duplicate the set digital block and place it below the else arm. select low from the drop-down. Use a forever block to run the code continuously. Place the WhenEvive starts up head block to execute the program. Upload the code using the upload button. Now that you know how to work with tactile switches or push buttons, you can use it in experiments for visualizing RC circuits, make scratch games such as dodge, and even use it to make advanced projects like a 3D pinball machine. That's it for this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more such educational content, subscribe to STEMpedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.